Rammstein right now! I know that doesn't look like a Chainsmokers set, right? It feels like Rammstein or a rock group or something. But I mean, you actually have live instruments, you don't have poppy songs that you would expect in a Chainsmokers set. So the set in itself is actually quite good, huh? If I told you, hey, do you want to come to the Chainsmokers set? I have tickets. What you will probably expect will be that. But actually, the Chainsmokers set has nothing to do with their music. They have received a lot of hate when it comes to their music because it's like really commercial. It's not the most complicated chords, melodies, or drums ever, honestly. And the lyrics are a little bit cliché. It's not Shakespeare, okay? It's not Shakespeare. But yeah, I mean, at least they make their songs like 100%. They make the lyrics, they make the beat. They sing in it. So, I mean, fair enough. There are like artists that make shitty songs with a lot of producers, a lot of songwriters. So it's something. But I mean, you that you're watching this video, I ask you to give them an opportunity because their set is actually really good. And I'm gonna explain it with data. So let's start. Okay, so first of all, what I'm gonna do is compare artists who played on the Ultra 2019 main stage at night. So I'm gonna compare the Chainsmokers, Martin Garrix, Marshmello, Afrojack, and Alesso. The Chainsmokers played 1 hour 30 minutes and they played 52 songs, 84 if we include mashups and acapellas, and 40 of that were their own songs or remixes that they made. Okay, so if we actually compare to the other artists, we will see that like Martin Garrix and Alesso have a completely different approach, which is mainly, hey, I have a few songs, I'm gonna showcase my stuff, and I want the set to be like more commercial. While you have Marshmello, Afrojack, and the Chainsmokers. The Chainsmokers actually are the ones that play the most songs and that they mix the most with the acapellas and mashups, at least in this set, in the Ultra. And they play a fair amount of their shit, you know, they play like 48% of own songs or remixes. So it's quite nice. And I wasn't expecting to get these results now. A good way to know if an artist makes a good DJ set is to see if he repeats the same set in different festivals. And I thought, okay, so the Chainsmokers have a really good show. I'm sure they're not going to use the same songs. They're gonna make it different depending on each festival. But no! Fuck no. I was so disappointed. They played almost the same completely set in the Tomorrowland Weekend 1, Weekend 2, and at Ultra 2019 Europe. It's almost the same set, only 3 songs change. 3 or 4 in the whole 1 hour something set. Come on. I mean, if you're doing a fucking live show, then it's okay. Like, it's just a normal concert. You play your live show, you play the same songs every time, and that's okay. But if you're doing a DJ set, the DJ set, you're supposed to change the music to put one song or a different one, depending on the crowd. So if the crowd is slow, they are not dancing, you choose a different song. If you put the same fucking set list, it just doesn't make sense for you to be DJing if you're gonna play the same song over and over. What's funny about that? Sorry, just a quick commercial break. Well, commercial, I'm not making any money out of that. It's just like pure personal interest. I have a Spotify playlist with a lot of good songs. It's not just EDM, it's rock, all genres. So it's just music that I like. So if you want to follow the playlist, it's in the description, the link. Goodbye, thank you. Okay, so it feels like I've been just saying negative things, but actually the Chainsmokers sets are really good. And I say that because of mainly 3 points. The first point is that the song selection is actually unexpected. Like, you wouldn't expect the songs that they play usually. So you would expect songs like Paris or Closer, which are like more radio commercial friendly. But no, they don't play this shit. But they play remixes that are more festival friendly. So they play, for example, Don't Let Me Down, the remix. Do you know the Don't Let Me Down, this one? So they play the remix, which the drop is way more amazing than the normal one. Same thing goes for something just like this. So the remix is actually quite amazing, as you can see in here. It's second point is that they really like to add performances. Not a lot of DJs actually add performances to their show, and I think that when it comes to music, it doesn't really add much, but it's a good way to make a good show. For example, 2018, it feels just like a low-cost Olympics. It's not that great, right? But in 2019, it's actually quite nice, like with the big drums and like the fire and everything. I mean, it doesn't require much skill, right? But I mean, it's still cool. There is a point where like one of them loses the fire, but it's still cool, right? I mean. Lastly, the third point is that they actually try to put a lot of live instruments in the show. So there is one of them that is singing, the other one usually plays the piano, well, the piano, the keyboard. And there is also, of course, this drummer that they found on YouTube, and he's amazing at drums. But also they usually invite a lot of singers. And it's nice to see that they are trying to incorporate live instruments and a live show, and not just a pre-recorded set, like a lot of them do. And for example, you can see here in Lollapalooza as well, in Chicago, they did a performance with Bebe Rexha. I don't know. And I don't know if the guitar is actually live. I'm gonna say that it's live. I hope it's live, but I don't know, honestly. So it's quite cool. It's something that you don't see in a lot of DJ sets. You only, maybe I remember Kashmir, but it's not really common to see a live show like this in a lot of DJs. So yeah, that was it. I would appreciate really if you follow my Spotify playlist, if you subscribe to my YouTube channel, and if you like the video, I just give a like, because that helps a lot. And it helps, you know, because I'm right now, I don't have a job. So, you know, if I can have 2 or 3 euros at the end of the month, it's better. So, hey, well, hopefully I don't get copyrighted.